minute. Steve Keirn has just hit the ring referee. Ooh, Keirn caught in the throat. And Keirn. Keirn after that. Keirn after that. Look at. Oh, no. Mike, it is Don Muraco. Confusion here. A challenge had been issued by Hito and Sakurada, but Mike Graham and Steve Keirn had already signed a contract to wrestle against the Mass Terror and the Gestapo, and Masao Hattori out here trying to get the Gestapo and the Mass Terror out of this match. The referee now having more problems, and it is Hito and Sakurada. So the referee removing them from the ring. As I said, of course, a contract had been signed. I'm sure that Mike Graham and Steve Keirn would wrestle them right now as far as that part of it goes. However, with the contract, it will be the Gestapo and the Masked Terror. So it's the Gestapo moving out first against Steve Keirn. Keirn very quickly gets him into a side headlock. Keirn fired off the rope, catches the Gestapo, a good shoulder smash. Keirn off the ropes again. That time, beautiful move by Keirn. Beautiful souple by Keirn. Keirn moving in on his man, keeps the ride. Gestapo trying to sit out, trying to escape. Keirn maintaining a ride on him. Float over Keirn, maintaining dominance here. Front chancery into the ropes. Gestapo moving away. Keirn electing to stay in the ring. Graham had offered to tag, but Keirn elected to stay. The tag is made. Mike Graham with a side headlock. Graham, a good takedown. Gestapo tried to bring him up. Graham forced the weight, brought him over, maintained the hold. Gestapo now with a head scissors on Mike Graham. Graham turns into his man. Slips out very nicely back on his feet into a hip lock takedown. And it was Graham setting ready as he came out of that. Is made, the Masked Terror moves in. Arm drag takedown very quickly by the Terror. Caught by Graham this time. Good move by the Terror. Came in and swept an ankle, and as Graham tried to break it up, the Terror dropped it. Good back out by the Terror, but finally reversing that situation. Good escape. And reversal into the arm bar. Again, the tag is made. This time, Steve Keirn moves in. Keirn with a full arm drag and twist. Tag is made. The Gestapo tags in. Uh-uh. catching Keirn in the throat. Keirn, good fireman Gary takedown, and kept the armbar. Arm drag and twist again by Keirn. Bottomless rock, a lateral drop, takedown. Back at the middle of ring ropes, and a Gestapo ripping across the face of Mike Graham on the break. Makes the tag. Terror. They double team. They've got Graham caught in that side headlock. Graham breaks feet, caught with a shoulder smash, dropped to the canvas. Graham caught again, dropped to the canvas once again. This time, Graham. Well executed backdrop on the masked Terror. Wait a minute. That mask came off. The mask came off of the masked Terror. I'm trying to get a look at that. Gordon Nelson. It's Gordon Nelson. But beautiful roll up and the Terror leaving the ring. Wait a minute. There comes Hito and Sakurada. Hito and Sakurada in there. They've got Mike Graham tied up in the ropes. And Masao Hattori pounding away at Mike Graham. Graham comes out of it. Hito and we've got Hito and Mike Graham hurdles him over the top rope, and now he's after Sakurada. He's got, and now it's Steve Keirn against the Gestapo. The Gestapo hurdle out of the ring, and now wait a minute. They're after Masao Hattori, and he slips out in a hurry. Masao Hattori slipping out of that ring in a hurry. I'll guarantee you that. He decided it was time to leave. And there you see them, the victors in that match. And they unmask the masked Terror. There they are. What a tag team combination. Mike Graham and Steve Keirn.
Okay, apparently it's going to be Ray Candy going up against Ox Baker. Killer Khan. I'm confused here because Ox Baker was originally scheduled to wrestle against Killer Khan, but now Ray Candy apparently has issued the challenge and it has been met. So we have quite a contest going here. Danny circling and being wary of this man, Killer Carl, Killer Khan. He's a dangerous, dangerous individual. You know, Pat, I know you were here last week and you saw what happened to Jack Brisco, and you're familiar with this man, Con, are you not?
I certainly am. I was on tour in the Orient with Jack Brisco when he was World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, and supposedly Killer Khan had issued a challenge to the world champion, Jack Brisco, in Japan. Jack Brisco didn't wrestle Killer Khan in Japan, but he did wrestle another Japanese wrestler by the name of Giant Baba over there, and that's when Giant Baba defeated Jack Brisco. And I'm very, very familiar with the match because I was Jack's corner man. And anyway, subsequently, Jack Brisco defeated Baba a few weeks later in Japan and regained his title. However, Khan is going around telling everybody that he can talk to and who listen that he was the one that issued the challenge to Jack Brisco, and Jack Brisco refused to meet him.
In your opinion, after what we saw what last week, do you think Khan could beat him?
Well, Khan is a very, very dangerous man, and I've got to get off that limb once again. I think so.
Well, there you have it. Khan now defeating Ray Candy. Killer Khan defeating Ray Candy using the claw. And so there you have your victor, Killer Khan.
Jack and Jerry Brisco moving up Slinker. You see him out there. Jack Brisco, former world heavyweight champion. Slinker rolling out of the ring. Jack Brisco standing there at this time, the referee, and Brisco watching his man. There you see Rick Oliver. Now it is Jerry Brisco moving in. Jerry and Jack Brisco, of course, outstanding athletes. Jerry Brisco in the blue trunks. They're up against the ring ropes now. Slinker trying to keep him tied up. Slinker, nationally rated in karate, exceptionally a dangerous competitor. Jerry Brisco caught him in the pit of the stomach coming off those ropes. But Jack and Jerry Brisco, of course, have wrestled together since childhood and have an intense concern for each other. Both went to Oklahoma State. Outstanding wrestling teams at Oklahoma State. Great rivalry between Oklahoma State and Oklahoma. In fact, the matter is you'll get as many people to the wrestling matches between those two colleges as you will basically to the football games. They have a great, great turnout. Oklahoma is certainly one of the great wrestling states in the entire United States, having turned out such competitors as Jack and Jerry Brisco, Danny Hodge, and of course the incomparable Cowboy Bill Watts, to name just a few. But there you see Slinker missing with a wild looping right hand. Jerry Brisco outside, watching carefully. Jack Brisco continues to work away at Slinker. Slinker caught him that time, a beautiful chop coming off the ropes. Brisco powers out before the count of three. Brisco held the World Heavyweight Championship for 2.5 years. Has been a dominant force in professional wrestling for a number of years. Twice NCAA champion, I might add. Both men crashing into each other and both men in trouble. Oliver reaching out trying to make that tag. Slinker having troubles, and Brisco dazed and stunned. The referee in a mutual count here. Jack Brisco trying to get over. Slinker has made the tag with Oliver. Oliver catches him a hard, hard right arm to the side of the jaw, now into a rear chin lock. Jerry Brisco obviously very concerned here, but he saw Brisco bring him up. Takes Oliver back to the canvas now. Jack Brisco back to his feet, makes the tag with brother Jerry. And Jerry Brisco moves in. Solid left hands and a right hand that put Oliver back to the canvas. Of course, the tactics that were used during this match, the Briscoes, I feel, were certainly very, very justified in all of the things that they did do, because they had a tremendous problem. There you go, that Oklahoma Bulldog has Slinker to the canvas. The tag is made. Jack Brisco moves in. Grapevine, three-quarter Nelson, and it is all over. And that's the one great thing, of course, about Jack and Jerry Brisco. They will go back to the basics as often as they can. They have a tremendous basic knowledge of amateur wrestling. They utilize that every opportunity they have, and so you see them disappear from the ring now.
It's a shame in today's world that people can't mind their own business. I heard that little punk out here, that little mealy-mouth Keirn out here, talking, if he can, this match ain't gonna take me very long. If he feels he's man enough, if he's ready to break another leg, then have him step up in that ring anytime he's ready.
Wow. The magnificent M, obviously incensed over what happened. There he goes into the ring. Let's turn it to the ring announcer.
This match is for one fall of a 10-minute time run. Introducing from Atlanta, weighing 255 pounds, Big Bill Dromo. From parts unknown, weight unknown, the magnificent M.
Okay, the Magnificent M going up against Big Bill Dromo. We saw him in action last week for the first time. He used that controversial Asiatic spike, Dromo. Big, powerful man. Duck under, go behind, reversal. Standing switch, a standing switch by Dromo. M catching him with elbows coming off the ropes. Big Bill Dromo wrestled in the Canadian National Games. Is big and tough, and he might put a halt to... No, sir, Magnificent M stood in that time, caught him coming in. Full body slam. Moves in against him again. Another full body slam on Dromo, and Dromo having... He's gone with the... he's got the spike. He's got the spike, and Dromo writhing in agony, trying to fight away from it now. And you can... Well, the noise he's making is... The referee calling for the bell. The referee calling for the bell. It's all over for Dromo. It is all over for Dromo. magnificent end falling for Steve Keirn, but he had chip. There you see in the magnificent end, and
wait a minute, Steve Keirn has just hit the ring referee. Ooh, Keirn caught in the throat. Keirn caught in the throat by the magnificent end. The referee sure didn't realize it, tried to stop Kern's attack, and the magnificent M out there after him now has Keirn in trouble, caught him, sundered him with that, and he sent, wait a minute, there they are, Jack Brisco, Jerry Brisco, Ray Candy, Mike Graham, all stopping the magnificent M, and Keirn after that, look at, oh, no, Mike, I can't believe this. It is Don Muraco. It is Don Muraco. But look at him. Look at this man. Don Muraco, like a man, a world unto himself. Look at him. Wild-eyed and absolutely no hair on his head whatsoever, a shaved skull. And there's no question about the fact that it is...
Sonny King can't buy me! Money can't buy me! I've been all over the world! I've been everywhere! And I'm sick! And I'm tired! And I'm sick! I became being called Jack Brisco! I can't stand being called a Brisco! I created... You've heard of the Destroyer! You've heard of wrestling too! I became Don Muraco! Became the Magnificent M! And with this... With this, I created my own identity. Nobody. It's just like a lynching. One guy slips the noose around the neck, but everybody's responsible. Everyone. And one by one, every man out here I have in my brain, one by one, everybody's gonna pay. Everybody's gonna pay.
I really don't know what to say at this point in time. It says that money is not the thing, but it certainly appears that he is a member of Sonny King's group, but we'll be back in a moment. Heavyweight champion going up against Frank Dusek. This is Gordon Soley at ringside. Now, Frank Dusek, by the way, is a second-generation wrestler. He's the son of the famous Wally Dusek, the Dusek brothers, who wrestled years back and were just outstanding competitors. Frank Dusek went on to... outstanding in wrestling most of his amateur career, went on in high school and in football, and went on to Citadel under an academic scholarship, although he could have easily qualified under an athletic scholarship. He spent 4 years in the Navy as a naval officer, came out of that, and then went back to his first love and the love of his family, and that, of course, professional wrestling. So Harley Race is not facing a newcomer to the wrestling ring, nor is he facing a newcomer in regards to wrestling philosophy. Race, on the other hand, caught in the midsection. That time the champion dropped, and it is Dusek. Putting a knee across that chest and very quickly into a rear chin lock. Harley Race, twice world heavyweight champion, won it first in 1973, lost it the same year, then won it back in 1977, and he is the only wrestler I know of ever to defeat two brothers for the world title. He first defeated Dory Funk Jr. for the World Heavyweight Championship in 1973. Then, after Jack Brisco defeated him, Brisco was ultimately defeated by Terry Funk in Miami in 1975. It was then Harley Race who met Terry Funk in Toronto, Canada, 1977, February 6th. And Race regained the title for a second time. One of the few men in wrestling ever to hold the NWA title more than one time. Modified fireman carry takedown by Harley Race. And Race caught Dusek coming in. Race's career as a professional began when he was 17 years old. A year later, he was critically injured in an automobile accident. It was stated then by the doctors they doubted if he'd ever walk again, but he was done as an athlete. He has then gone on to achieve the World Heavyweight Championship on two different occasions. Certainly a tribute to this man's great, great intestinal fortitude. Race using that knee into the prefrontal lobe of Frank Dusek. Has Dusek in a lot of pain. Race drives that knee into the forehead once again. This, of course, rocks the brain in its fluid solution and can cause a short circuit. Race now, Salto, well executed by the champion. Harley Race, an 18-year veteran of the ring wars, and without a doubt, one of the most well-fought champions the NWA has ever had. Race, double underhooking, brings his man up and over. Double underhook into a souplé. And again, Dusek powers out. Great credit goes to this young Frank Dusek. Dusek hurtled off those ropes, and Race caught him with a knee coming in. And Dusek now, methodically, being demolished by the World Heavyweight Champion. And one thing about Race, he has his own philosophy going, and he says, any man who thinks he's man enough to step in the ring with me is welcome to try. Has him up, that vertical souple, down, and that has to be all she wrote for young Frank Dusek. And it is indeed, again, NWA World Heavyweight Champion Harley Race. Moving on victoriously, being presented his belt by the referee. We'll take a look at that in instant replay.
Pat O'Connor is my special guest commentator today, lending his expertise to these matches. And thus far, I would say we've seen a lot of excitement.
Yes, some exceptional wrestling here today, Gordon. And this match here right in the ring right now is going to get a little exciting as these wrestlers warm up.
Thor the Viking, of course, highly unpredictable, a big man. He outweighs Keirn by, I would say, close to 70-some-odd pounds. Keirn now with a ride. Light post on the arm. Keeps a ride now. The Viking back up on one knee, back to his feet. Keirn still behind his man, but they're into the ring ropes, and the referee calls for the break. There again, Thor was using his weight to his own advantage.
He certainly is. He's going to be leaning on Keirn as long as he can to tire him out and weaken his neck and shoulder muscles.
Side chancery by Thor the Viking now. And Keirn is going to be hard-pressed to move out of this. Thor the Viking continues to apply that pressure. And, of course, that arm is also coming across that carotid artery, a back leg trip. Keirn, good reversal here into a hammerlock. Keirn has developed that mean streak, which is so necessary to take you over that edge into victory.
That is, that's necessary in all sports to have that little meanness to come right on when necessary. And Keirn has developed that, and I don't see any lingering injury to that ankle of his that he hurt last year.
Now there you have it, an expert's professional observation that Keirn appears to be 100% recovered. It is Thor the Viking lashing out with the right hand being warned by the referee now. The Viking drives a knee into the side of the head of Steve Keirn, drives him into the mat. And Keirn, taking a lot of punishment here, now suddenly catches him. One to the midsection, but Thor the Viking closes in with that knee again.
He's a big, aggressive wrestler.
Keirn, driven to the canvas that time, caught the back of the elbow. However, before the count could really get started, there's a victory here on television, extremely important for either competitor. Millions of people watching it.
It certainly would elevate both wrestlers in the ratings in this area and the United States with a good win on television here.
And that one would have collapsed the chest of an average man, I believe, Pat.
I certainly think so, too, Gordon.
I think this is something else, too, that so many people feel that they can get out and compete in the pro ranks, trying to get out and compete as a professional wrestler without having the background, the desire, the training. Beautiful forearms that drove him down. Tremendous forearms by Steve Keirn. It took two of them to get that massive Thor the Viking off his feet. Thor the Viking stunned, and I don't think he really knew it hit him that second time. But certainly an outstanding victory for him. And watch him now. Keirn coming off the ropes. We're in slow motion. Caught him. Jarred the head.
That caught him right under the ear, Gordon, and stoned him for that three-second count.
And that's all it took. There you have a fine victory for Steve Keirn. Box Baker has joined me right now, and a challenge was issued, Mr. Baker.
Well, word just got to me that this big mouth Sonny King, who I wanted to beat up in Florida, word has just got to me that he wants to try this hard punch of mine on TV against some so-called bolo punch. I haven't seen this thing, but a lot of people have seen this big fist of mine drive into people and hurt people, and accept that anywhere he wants, anytime. I want to put this hard punch on
the
TV.
All right, I'll tell you what, you said you didn't get a chance to see it. We're going to take a look at it right now. We're going to watch Sonny King, and something that amazed me, he threw a Kid Gavilan bolo punch at young Buzz Sawyer, knocked him out. Let's take a look at exactly how that happened just a little while ago.
It really looked like it really almost knocked the wind right out of him. He's in trouble. He's in bad trouble now.
He bolo punched him. I haven't seen a bolo punch like that since Kid Gavilan. Well, there you have it. Most effective punch. There's no question about that. It just slap knocked him out.
You know, I just think Sonny King had something in his fist or something. I don't think he can put a couple upside of my jaw. I know that nobody's been able to stop this hard punch, and I know that Sonny King won't be able to stop it either.
All right, then you're saying that next week you'll meet him. The bolo
anywhere. If he wants to meet me,
right
just
here
see right on television. That's where I'd
all
love
right,
to see
there you have it.
I'd love to see him
there
throw right on
it.
His face.
Sonny King with his bolo punch against Ox Baker with his heart punch here on Championship Wrestling from Florida next week. And that is something that everybody better be watching for, because that is going to be a confrontation. Well, thank you for coming out.
I'm
going to
bring my stretcher out here. They're going to carry him in that dressing room, because I'm going to put that hard punch not once, but maybe five times into his body.
Okay. Ox Baker has accepted the challenge. We'll see it next week here on Championship Wrestling from Florida. Until then, this would be Gordon Solie saying so long from the Sunshine State.
I'm gonna pay.